The last test I did trying to confine wax to keep it from burning showed me that with just an open top, that was not enough confinement to keep wax from the oxygen of the outside air and prevent it from lighting on fire, thus defeating the point of vaporizing wax. I also have the desire to make my reactions more consistent. In the first test that I did, I would have them just out in the open air or wrapped in newspaper, and I found that the newspaper would cause the reactions to go a lot faster. It seems like adding more confinement might really help with making the reactions go faster, so I want to make sure that the confinement I'm using is very predictable. So that is why I got these pieces of pipe that I can use as reaction vessels. I have holes in the top of these, which, due to a little bit over-enthusiastic angle grinding, did not turn out to be the grind it down some to reduce the amount of drilling to have a nice round hole. I will do that in the future. For this test, to mitigate that, I'll be using the same cap on both tests so that there is limited difference between the two of them. What I am going to be doing in this test is filling these each with just the powdered mixture, which I prepared together so that they'd be exactly the same, and then separated into 20-gram batches. I'll be putting each of these, except in one of them I'm going to be tamping it down, whereas the other one I'm just going to leave it loose. The reason I'm doing this is in the last test, just a straight ground up potassium nitrate and sugar seemed to go very aggressively, almost like a rocket. And I want to see if that's the result of tamping it down or the result of this confinement. Because where this potassium nitrate is going to be down fairly deep in these reaction vessels, I'm going to need to have fuses to light them off. To make these fuses, I'm using potassium nitrate and sugar mixture, which I'm then going to wrap up inside newspaper. I'm using this little skewer to roll the paper around, to like pre-roll it into the same kind of the direction I want it to go, because it'd be really hard to start that, I think, without pre-rolling it. And then I'm just putting some of this mixture in. This mixture I ground up even finer than I normally do for the smoke bombs, such that it will hopefully be like able to run better on the with the less amount of it. And this will be going vertically down, so that will also hopefully help. And then just roll it up some amount, cutting it off, and then tape the ends and once in the middle. This is kind of messy, but I'm not going for super clean amounts. We'll hopefully keep it in enough for moving it outside to light these off. This will hopefully not have it all end up on one end. Some charcoal inside, but that I think fully combusted. Definitely did. And that is hot, even through leather gloves and wool mittens. On to the next one.
both cases, it seemed to produce less smoke than normal. This compacted seemed to burn much more aggressively. There's less charcoal. That's hot. There's less charcoal in the compacted. Like less leftover carbon. I guess there's some at the bottom, but I think generally less. Seemed to burn better, though not completely clean at all, but that's to be expected. There's even a little bit of potassium nitrate in here.
Though not the main goal of this video, the results showed that the fuses I just quickly put together worked well. I might try to refine them in the future. Unlike what I asserted immediately after the test, before reviewing the footage, the compacted sample burned slower than the uncompacted sample, but not by all that much. Comparing all the tests I have done with 20 gram samples of ground up 40% sugar and 60% potassium nitrate, it seems that the confined samples burn slower than the unconfined samples, or I should really say the samples that were just wrapped up in newspaper. However, due to the small sample size of the confined samples and difference in the fusing lighting arrangement between confined and unconfined samples, it is not certain that this is the case. That was not the focus of this test, and I had not previously considered this an area of study. What this test was mainly designed to do was to be something I could put together very quickly and just test out that these reaction vessels would work, and just kind of had the theory behind me using these reaction vessels made sense for me to continue that before I put in a lot of effort to making more of them. Those reaction vessels seem to work well. However, compared to the open air tests, the less smoke they produce is concerning. However, due to the longer burn times, it is entirely possible that in total they produce the same amount of smoke. It is just spread out over a longer time and thus is not as visible or otherwise as noticeable compared to those open air tests, which just go up all in a poof. And so you really see a lot of smoke, whereas this is more spread out. It's also that the background of this test was kind of the white snow, and so it may have hid the smoke somewhat. But I find it really hard to compare smoke, so I've generally not been pursuing that aspect of testing, even though arguably that's what the point of making smoke bombs is the smoke.
Because I made an extra fuse, because the one that I actually made on camera I didn't think was good enough, and I had some extra of the fuse making material, I'm going to try lighting it off. This is horizontal fuse, which is a good test. Gotten too windy. Go grab the blowtorch. That fuse burned up really quickly, just like shot through there. So this does seem to be a very effective fuse making method, which is, I guess, a secondary benefit that I wasn't really trying to test, but ended up doing.